Here is a Dell Slim Studio 540S slimline tower computer that can also be used as a desktop because it has feet on the side here. It has a dual core Pentium and Windows 7. Front panel audio and USB. On the back it has SPDIF digital audio output, VGA, FireWire 400, 4 USB 2.0 ports, Ethernet, HDMI, and surround sound audio. So I guess this was supposed to be a home theater PC because of the surround sound, the HDMI output, and the SPDIF digital output. It has low profile expansion slots. Also has a DVD drive, but the one thing it's missing is a floppy drive. So I wanted to add one in the space here. They give you a 3.5-inch bay. But if we peek at just the right angle under the optical drive, we can see the pinout for the floppy drive cable is not populated. It's just bare solder pads on the motherboard. And also in the BIOS setup is disabled. There's not even an option for the floppy drive. But I was able to find this on eBay. It's an adapter board that converts a standard internal floppy drive to a USB port. It's a little bit expensive. It costs about $17, but it's pretty much your only option for being able to use a floppy drive internally in a computer that doesn't have a real floppy drive controller. So it just plugs into the standard 34-pin floppy connector. Only supports 3.5-inch 1.44 megabyte floppy drives. Does not support 5.25, and as we'll see later, it also does not support 720K disks. Won't even let you format a disk to 720K, so it's only high density 1.44 megabyte. We get this power connector to power it off of USB. Obviously, if your power supply has a connector for the floppy drive, you can just use that instead of powering it through the USB. But this gives us a standard external type USB port. But to convert that into something that we can plug into the motherboard, I bought this on eBay. So with this adapter, we can plug this into one of the USB internal headers on the motherboard here. You can see there are several unused ones here. These support two USB ports each, so it'll only take up one half of it. You can see this one is already taken up by the front panel USB ports. But they actually have three more connectors here, so there's plenty of expansion here for more internal USB ports. Okay, disaster averted. Turns out this floppy drive wasn't going to fit in this case with this converter board plugged into the back of it, like I showed you, because it was hitting against the motherboard power connector. But I found this weird floppy cable that has not only the usual plugs on it, but also a socket. I think this might have been designed for a tape backup drive, and I had no use for this. This was just sitting in my junk box. But turns out I can use this little piece here as an extender cable to get this converter board out of the way so I can fit in the case. So I'll just cut off the rest of this cable and use this little piece here as an extender. And it turns out this power supply does have a connector for a floppy drive, so I don't need to use this power cable here. I can just power it directly from the power supply. So there's my custom-made extender cable. Now obviously you won't need to do this if you have a case with enough room in it to mount a floppy drive without this thing hitting against anything. So this is just something special I had to make to fit it into this slimline case. And I already tested this by plugging this into my laptop and it worked fine. Windows recognized the driver for this right away and it was able to read this disk. So I know it works. Here is the floppy drive installed, and it's actually held in place with copious amounts of Gorilla tape because apparently Dell designed this 3.5-inch bay to use some kind of drive rails, which I don't have, so there were no screw holes to mount it in, so I had to improvise. And here's how tight of a fit it is. That little extender cable I fabricated gave me just enough room to put this circuit board sitting on top of the RAM sticks, so I insulated it with some electrical tape just to make sure the contacts didn't short out. So that's kind of flapping around in the breeze there, as EEV blog would say, but it's not really going anywhere. Then you can see the USB cable with some horrible cable management here, with this adapter cable finally connecting to the pin header on the motherboard. So not a very clean installation, but this is not designed to win any beauty contests. It's just designed to get it working. As you can see, The USB floppy drive is recognized by the BIOS setup as a bootable device, so that means I can take my Super MS-DOS 7.1 boot disk and use it to boot the computer. And there it is, booting off of the floppy drive. And here we have our startup menu. Going nowhere real fast. They need to unwind, relax, let them know. They were playing 10,000 songs in a row, commercial free. The new 98.1 Breeze. There we are at the DOS prompt on the floppy disk. Whole bunch of files on that disk. It's actually full, 0 bytes free. Now here's what happens when we try to format a 720K double density disk in this drive. You can see this disk does not have the HD logo on it, indicating that it is not a high density 1.44 megabyte disk. It's only 720K. I just formatted this in my IBM ThinkCenter and it formatted fine at 720K with no bad sectors. Now I'm going to try to format it in this drive, and at first it looks like it's going to work, but that's going way too fast for a floppy drive format. Interested to see what happens here, because I told it unconditional format, so it's not like it was doing a quick format. Obviously something went wrong there. It's showing 2.9 megabytes of disk space and 2.7 megabytes in bad sectors. So obviously that format did not work because the USB controller does not support 720K. The floppy drive is recognized in Windows, and when I try to format a 720K disk in Windows, it gives a more sensible result saying parameters not supported by drive. And a high density 1.44 megabyte disk did format correctly in Windows. I will include a link in the description to the eBay listing for the USB adapter I bought. Of course, eBay listings don't last forever, so if this one ever becomes unavailable, it may be difficult to find another place selling these, because as you can see, it has no brand name or model number. It just says 34-pin floppy connector to USB adapter cable. So I guess you'll just have to type that in and see what comes up. The seller is in Hong Kong, and for some reason they listed the price in British pounds, but I had no trouble buying it from my US PayPal account, and took about a week and a half to get here. And they show it installed in the drive like I did. Like I said, it cost about $17, which is a little bit pricey, but if you want to get a floppy drive and a computer that doesn't have an actual floppy drive controller, this is pretty much your only way to do it with an internal drive.